everyone, how are you doing? My name is Aditi, and in today's video, we will talk about all the probable interview questions that you could be asked when you apply for your design admissions. If you've applied to any design school, then you must be knowing that most design schools will first have a prelim round, which is a written round, and if you clear that, you're called for the situation test or the studio test. And after that, some colleges will also have an interview round. If this interview round is happening in your design school, then please make sure to watch this video till the end, because today we will talk about all the probable questions a little bit in detail, and I will share with you a few do's and don'ts that we can keep in our mind and hopefully even increase our chances of getting that admission we always wanted. So on that note, let's not waste more time and let's start with the video. The first most probable question is, tell me something about yourself. To answer this question, we can talk about our school, our college, our academics, all the subjects that we've studied. We can talk about our strengths, something that we are confident about. And we can also talk about our special skills. These skills could be any hobbies that you have recently picked up, but it is important that we are very honest with our answer. So if you say that I love singing or dancing or coding, whatever your answer is, we have to be prepared to answer questions about it. If you say I can sing or I love singing, then it is very likely that some professor might actually ask you to sing. They might actually ask you to dance if you say that I love dancing. So we have to be prepared for that situation as well. Second question, where are you from and what is this place famous for? Now, the professor or your judge is not so interested in geographical details. They're actually trying to see how good you are with questions and how curious you are as a person. To be a good designer, it is very important that we enjoy details and we love exploring things around us. So if you say that, for example, I'm from Kerala, then they expect you to know something which is very special about Kerala. Is it the food, the culture, art, craft, handlooms, dance forms? It could be anything. If you know about it, then make sure to speak about it and it will show that you enjoy details. Third question, where do you live and what do your parents do? We have to keep in mind that the professors are not so interested in our family paychecks or salaries that our parents get. They want to know how good we are at observing details. So if we say my mom's a manager or my dad's an engineer, that shows that we don't like exploring things around us. Instead, we need to talk about what exact role do our parents play in the company. What are their job responsibilities? What kind of teams they lead? If you know this answer very well, it sets a very good impression on your professors. Next probable question, why do you want to be a designer? Or what is design according to you? It can be a little tricky at first. So I'm going to give you a rough idea of how you can maybe frame your answer. You can maybe say that design is a rare combination of science and art. It is one of those fields in which we solve everyday problems in an aesthetic way. And the most amazing part is that a good design can make every service more eco-friendly and user-friendly at the same time. This is why I'm very interested about it. Next question, which is your favorite product and why? If you want to be a car designer, then which is your favorite car and why? To be able to answer this question, of course, we need to read about all the cars and products around us, and we can answer this question however we like it, but we have to keep in mind that we don't just focus on the aesthetics. The car looks very cool, so I like it. It looks very expensive, so I want to buy it. Is not a very strong reason. We have to support it with something which is slightly more functional. We have to talk about the functionality, because design is not just about beautification. So if you say that you like a car, then there must be something very special about the car. Is it the comfort of the seat? Is it the material of the car? Is it very eco-friendly? Something that sets it different from the other cars in the market. If you know that one quality, then you must talk about it. Next question, who is your favorite designer? And for this, you need to take out a few hours of your day and you need to Google all the top designers in the world and you need to quickly read about them. The one designer that inspires you the most, make sure that you remember their name, where they are from, and what all things have they designed. So if you want to be a car designer, it is advisable that you know at least one car designer's name, where the designer is from, and what all cars they have designed. Next set of questions could be, why do you wish to join this college and how did you come to know about it? To be able to answer this question, of course, we have to read about the college we are applying to, and we should know what this college is famous for. And we need to mention that in this answer. If the professors ask you, what would you do if you don't secure a seat in this college? This is the only question in which we don't have to be 100% honest. We have to avoid taking names of any other fellow design schools and saying, this is my backup option, because it gives the impression that we don't have a focused approach. Instead, a much more humble and positive way of answering this question is by saying, I'll try my best to apply next year as well. The next set of questions could be about general knowledge or overall awareness. Questions could be about national or international topics, something like farmers' protests or the recent Suez Canal crisis. Why was it so important? Why was everybody talking about it? And if we have to answer all of these questions, it is obviously very important for us to read the news or watch the news and stay updated with the current events. Professors can also ask us a very hypothetical question. Let's say, imagine that you are the prime minister of your country for a day, then how would you contain this virus? Or they can ask you, can India afford a second lockdown? And of course, if we have to add more matter to our answer, it is important for us to have more information. And that will only be possible if we read the news or watch the news every day. The next set of questions could be about our artwork or portfolio. Our professors might ask us to show our artworks and speak about it, speak about our favorite artwork and what did we learn out of it. You can choose one artwork and you can elaborate on the process. There is no right or wrong way to explain this. You can do it in your own personal style. To give you a rough idea, you can say that this is my favorite artwork because this is something I made with my imagination and I enjoyed the process. This was the first time I experimented with watercolors and acrylics together at the same time. And I'm very fascinated by the fact that watercolors and acrylic paints have different properties with the same paper. Something like that. We don't have to always sound very superlative or impressive. We can also give very genuine answers at times. And with that, guys, it's a wrap for today's video. I really hope you found this video helpful. I wish you all the very best for your interview round. Whether you have an answer or you don't have an answer, make sure that you stay confident, you're persistent, and you're very, very honest. If you have all of these three qualities, I can assure you that your interview round will be as smooth as a cakewalk. It's not going to be difficult for you. Do tell me how's your experience. And take care of yourselves, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Bye bye.